Ông quý chọc President, please be seated. The chamber is back in session, and I would like to give the floor to the lead co-lawyers for civil party to put more questions to the expert. You may now proceed.
Reprise de l'audience, je vais passer la parole au cours à la co-avocate pour les parties civiles.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon to all of you. Good afternoon to you,
Mr. Hinton. And
we broke off before the lunch break on the issue of the NECTA, the question of the NECTA and the protection systems that were set up through the NECTA, through Buddhist creed, and the dependency links with influential people that you describe as
And I wanted to know if this patronage system, if this dependency system with influential people
offering you protection was something that was in effect in the villages before the decay period.
Thank you, Madame Civil Party Co-Lead Lawyer.
The quick answer is yes, before, during, and after, though,
as I've stressed before,
the
things do change over time, depending on the historical moment, but the sort of centralized, personalized relationship, that structure, which is found in different parts
Cette structure
of the world,
se trouve dans différentes régions du monde. Elle s'inscrit différemment dans le contexte
Cambodia,
local, en particulier au Cambodge.
Dans quelle mesure
and
les politiques du Cambodgia démocratique ont impacté
or did the decay policies have an impact on this patronage system as existed before these policies came into effect?
Thank you. Yes, the I guess there are two sides to it.
Il y a deux aspects.
On the one hand, the existing structures, patronage system,
les structures existantes, le système de patronage,
and again, when we talk about relationships
les relations de protégé à protecteur,
right,
les relations de dépendance.
We're talking about it in multiple senses, so
quand
we can talk about
de
it
différentes
on the
filières,
level,
il y a différents right, niveaux, le niveau du village, les relations
exist,
avec les esprits, il y a aussi
patrons in different contexts.
Les bienfaiteurs,
so
les protecteurs dans différents contextes.
The Khmer Rouge completely revamped society
les Khmer Rouge
in accordance with their new vision,
refaçonné la société entière selon leur nouvelle vision.
I'm quite consciously undermining these links, which could be a threat
ils ont
to the new society.
Affaibli ces liens qui pouvaient être une menace pour la nouvelle société. À leur place, ils ont installé un nouveau système de dépendance. Cela dit, eux insistaient sur l'égalité.
These links continue to persist,
ces liens
including, for example,
se sont maintenus,
in Kampong Siem district,
y compris à Kampong Siem. À l'arrivée de la grand-mère Yut, elle a amené avec elle des membres de sa famille, dont Rom. Ceci a pu asseoir son pouvoir. Elle avait des gens sur qui elle pouvait compter avec la création d'un réseau. Et revenons à ce qu'on a dit hier, les filières de traîtres qui sont largement citées à S21, cela, c'était des
réseaux
qui se sont fondés sur ces relations interpersonnelles.
Je vous remercie dans votre ouvrage et je me réfère
book,
ici à la page 265
page
qui n'a pas été traduite.
Which was not translated.
Vous expliquez que la vie dans les endroits où les cadres avaient des liens locaux était en général meilleur, surtout pour
was better,
le peuple de base,
especially for the base people,
ce qui a pu amener les dirigeants du Kampuchea démocratique à remplacer les cadres locaux
the local cadres,
afin que ceux-ci n'aient plus
so
de lien personnel
no
avec
any personal
les habitants du village. Est-ce que vous pouvez
local
un petit
people?
Peu expliquer
so
cette
explain,
dynamique que vous décrivez
bit,
dans votre ouvrage
in your book?
Uh,
Yes, thank you. So the question with regard to that question, there are a couple of different layers to it.
Il y a
so you had
niveaux.
Within different sectors
dans les différents
of DK secteurs, existing quote-unquote strings that existed. We've talked about the Goituin, the northern zone for an extensive patronage network there. So all of the different zones had these networks, relationships of personalized dependency, which were a threat, perceived threat by the DK regime, and got caught up as there was the perception that there were threats to the regime in these massive purges.
C'était perçu comme une menace,
so as
des
purges
took place,
they would, as I mentioned before, grandmother Yut, where she came in,
par exemple,
and systematically they replaced everyone there.
Yut a systématiquement remplacé les gens sur place. Ta'an était son supérieur.
At times, the DK regime
parfois,
would
cela dit,
put different factions
le régime
in the same area so that one faction did not get too much power. And so this was another dynamic that existed. With regard to, I've heard, in Region 41,
ensuite,
they would rotate
41,
the people who did the killing at times. There's no,
bourreaux,
it's not systematic, but the people who were doing the killing
in
the sub-district level
au niveau
would be
du
rotated
sous-district,
periodically
donc,
in order
périodique.
That they didn't come to know people so much.
Pour
so there were a number of different systems, but again, the notion that, as you saw when a second cadre, a village head came in Vong's village
dans
and
le visage
took the 30
de Long,
names,
exemple,
right, which he was listed on and didn't do anything about it, you can see how those relationships could play a part. And there are other factors where, cadre
rôle.
Could sometimes protect someone, so if there might be someone with a stigmatized background, the local authorities would have some
si
ability to protect them a tiny bit, and this occurred in other contexts,
par exemple,
such as Nazi Germany and different places as well.
Ceux qui se retrouvent dans d'autres contextes aussi, comme par exemple dans l'Allemagne nazie.
Je vous remercie. Vous parlez donc dans votre ouvrage, et ce sera ma dernière question sur ce sujet. Vous parlez dans votre ouvrage de l'affaiblissement général des systèmes de protection qui avaient été mis en place. Est-ce que vous pensez que cet affaissement des protections qui allait du surnaturel au politique ont pu avoir un impact sur la propension de certains à passer à l'acte ou au contraire sur
or
la capacité
on
de certains
the capacity
à résister
of some of them to resist the
par
policies that were set up by the DK regime.
So again, the dynamics vary. Temporally and spatially, so there can be variation in it. But certainly this dynamic of perceived relationships of dependency, patronage network, strings, there are many different terms for it, continue to inform
action
in DK. You can have it where, for example, the Khmer Republic officials, in
par
a
exemple,
sense,
les fonctionnaires
were people who had a different
Khmer,
linkage, right? There were all sorts of networks
sens,
that were viewed as threatening to the DK regime. So in one sense, that broad targeting of those groups, even as it's also linked to
et
class issues,
donc,
so on and so forth, that's one sweep in which
classes.
This is operative. So you're trying to quote-unquote clean up these links, but it also filters all the way down to the local countryside. So if you had different villages where you had a village head who was in an area,
the
Khmer Rouge came in, that person might be toppled or might be targeted and killed. It really depends on the time and the place. So these links continue to inform action in a variety of different ways.
Ces liens continué à être déterminants pour ce qui est des mesures qui étaient prises.
Je vous remercie. J'ai quelques
Thank
questions
you. I have
sur,
a few questions to put to you about the role of the family.
Vous dites dans
you
votre ouvrage que le,
book,
le foyer,
the home,
household,
or the
anglais,
household,
dans votre ouvrage,
fact,
et l'unité sociale
say,
première au Cambodge,
book, is the main social unit in Cambodia, and you describe the impact
qu'ont eu les politiques du Cambodge démocratique sur la famille.
Had on the household.
Et vous expliquez
and you
notamment
explain
que le CPK that the CPK would try to destroy the social and economic functions
of the household and of the family.
Ma première question and my first question is why was it important for the CPK to destroy this fundamental entity,
the household, the family?
Yes, I think once again, as with Buddhism, as well
comme
as village life, in a sense, these were potential
de
threats
de famille,
to the new regime.
Une menace potentielle
there were also
pour le nouveau régime.
Alternative sources of loyalty.
C'était
but part
aussi
of what
des sources
the DK regime
loyauté,
wanted to do, if we go back to, for example, Anka, was to take different attachments, emotional attachments that existed, and transfer them from those other sources
les attaches existantes
to the regime,
et les transférer vers
the notion of
le régime,
so would marry
avec la notion
couples.
Que c'était l'Ankar qui allait
Children
marier
would,
les couples,
you know, different songs
les enfants,
that exist, revolutionary songs speak about Ankar, how you should have gratitude towards Ankar.
Devait
so again, in the sort
dans
of
les différents
quasi,
champs, disait qu'il fallait être reconnaissant vers l'Ankar.
Quasi religious, quasi
donc
spiritual sense of Ankar. As being the parent, as being
l'idée
the
que l'Ankar
sort of divine being
était
that
une entité quasi religieuse, spirituelle,
began to forge new relationships
c'était les parents.
With. And so it took on many of the notions
il y avait donc une relation interpersonnelle avec l'Ankar.
L'Ankar
s'est donc approprié différentes formes de relations de dépendance, de gratitude qui existaient auparavant entre les gens d'une même famille. Et tous ces liens ont été remobilisés au service du régime. Cela faisait partie du projet de mise en place d'une nouvelle société.
And the young again were looked, as we've heard before, as blank pieces of paper upon which anything could be inscribed.
Les jeunes étant des pages blanches,
also used and spoken about during the DK regime. And the last thing, you know,
dernier
I should
point.
Also just mention that, and again, disbanding the family, having people work in sexually segregated work teams,
les
having children
séparées,
sometimes being kept apart from their parents,
séparées des parents.
The disbanding of the family. Those were all
la
systematic
était démantelée,
ways to mobilize and
celle
take
qui
this attachment and redirect it
de rediriger ces liens vers l'Ankar.
Many people speak about hating
beaucoup
to eat communally, and they very much missed
ne pas avoir
eating
aimé
together
manger
in the family
en
unit.
Commun,
when they would, so
the,
this
les
mentioned
repas familiaux
over and over again was the source
manquaient.
Of, I think, great suffering and upset to many people,
ce
as was, of course,
being,
having their family splintered, being under threat, having spies creep around
le fait
at night
que la famille
underneath
était
the houses and listen.
Qu'il y ait des gens
and you began
qui
to have this generalized atmosphere of distrust that also crept in and could also splinter a family. And I guess, you know, I returned to grandmother Yut being willing to kill
et
her husband or being okay with the order to have him killed.
Il y a le cas de la grand-mère Yut et de l'exécution de son mari qu'elle devait accepter.
Fragmentation, once again, of that relationship
encore un exemple d'une fragmentation
child,
de ces liens parents-enfants.
But it also, as I said before, was linked to the mobilization of
ce qui, comme
relationships
je l'ai dit,
of personalized dependency,
lié
whether it's from family, a former teacher, a former patron,
la transformation
so on, so
des relations parents-enfants, enseignants, élèves, protecteur protégé.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Vous évoquez dans votre ouvrage,
book,
à la page 130,
about, on page 130,
la situation et le rôle des enfants,
and the role
et
of
vous
children.
Évoquez les
and
sessions
you
d'endoctrinement des
the
enfants
indoctrination sessions that children
dont
had to undergo,
de parler un petit
which
peu.
You just spoke about a little bit in
pouvez-vous
fact.
Nous dire un mot
so
sur la
tell
façon
us,
dont le
few words about how the PCK
voyait les enfants
would
et
perceive
le rôle
children
qu'ils ont joué
and the role that
dans
children
le processus
played,
révolutionnaire.
In the revolutionary process.
Yes, thank you. The so again, part of it links to what I how I was responding before,
c'est
but I think also this issue speaks back to the notion of revolutionary consciousness.
À l'idée de conscience
and you have different groups. Each individual has a set
il y a
of tendencies,
chaque personne
sort of an essence,
a des tendances,
whether it's class-based, what have you,
essence,
and
la
needs
classe,
to struggle
exemple,
to purify themselves.
Il y a une
children,
lutte pour se purifier.
Since they hadn't grown up in what was formerly a capitalist society, were viewed as being
dans une société
more
capitaliste,
pure,
ils sont donc plus purs, ils peuvent être forgés, construits, devenir de
so
purs révolutionnaires.
Reason,
c'est pour
the children,
cela que l'État voulait que les enfants deviennent les enfants de l'Ankar.
With these regressive tendencies would be able to lead society to this, to a beautiful, better future.
Pour pouvoir bâtir un avenir plus radieux.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Vos recherches, vos entretiens,
in your research
vos ont-ils
and
permis de mesurer l'impact qu'avait eu cet endoctrinement sur les enfants,
impact
pendant le régime du
impact
grand
during
démocratique
regime,
et impact,
impact
à long terme
in the long term,
après
after,
la chute
the fall of the regime.
Thank you, Madame, Civil Party co-lawyer. I'm not sure by assess, if in terms of the translation, if assessment by that you meant an instrument
vous
of
dites,
assessment
dans la traduction,
or my own
assessment.
Personal assessment.
Vous parlez de ma propre
in terms
appréciation,
of, yeah, my own
assessment, si c'est ma propre appréciation,
there were often bonds between families
il y a souvent des
that were shattered or forged in different cases
entre familles qui ont été
due to the DK regime. You have
par le régime,
marriages that were done by Ankara were brought together with little choice.
L'Ankara
was one example. Afterwards,
mariages,
many of those families had to find a way to continue to
ensuite,
live together.
Les familles en question ont dû
divorcing and the potential stigma
essayer
that comes with
de
that.
Rester ensemble pour
people
éviter
had children. Some
le
divorce
stigmatisant.
Never told their children they were married during this period.
Des enfants.
So you have, you know, arranged marriages.
Après ces mariages,
legacy of
arrangés, ça c'est un leg laissé par ce régime.
Other people have sort of talked about a
d'autres gens ont parlé de la méfiance généralisée qui a persisté par la suite dans les familles. Il y a aussi la résilience, les gens ont reconstruit leur vie. Ce faisant, jusqu'à aujourd'hui, beaucoup se souviennent du passé, ils en souffrent encore, mais ils ont de la résistance, ils sont allés de l'avant, ils ont reconstruit leur vie.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Dans votre ouvrage,
in
en introduction,
book,
vous
in
expliquez que
explain,
le peuple nouveau et le peuple de base a été radicalement affecté de manière différente par les politiques du Cambodgia démocratique. Pouvez-vous expliquer quel a été l'impact principal des politiques sur ces deux groupes
et en quoi ces deux groupes ont été impactés de façon différente.
Yes. The groups were impacted
ces groupes
in different
ont été
ways.
Affectés
the
différemment.
New people were stigmatized
le peuple
in general.
Nouveau a été stigmatisé de façon générale, étant considéré
less sharp
comme
revolutionary
ayant une conscience révolutionnaire
suspect,
moins vive,
because of the environment,
étant
the capitalist
suspect
environment,
de par l'environnement capitaliste
of in which they'd grown up,
de propriété privée dans lequel il avait grandi.
So they were stigmatized.
I should note
that
également,
it would be inaccurate, though,
tel.
To say,
toutefois,
and I'm not
faux,
suggesting you implied this, but I think it's important
que
sometimes
l'affirmiez.
People don't talk about the base people this way. But the base people also suffered
a great
deal.
Dire que les gens du peuple de base n'ont pas souffert.
Anyway,
ils ont souffert aussi. Certains
the
sont morts.
Base people suffered, though,
le peuple
I think
de base
clear, for example,
a souffert aussi,
the demographics, number of
même
people
si
killed, for example,
la démographie des gens tués le montre,
more.
Les nouveaux ont souffert davantage
people,
que le peuple de base. Mais à Banyan, par exemple, c'était surtout des gens du peuple de base.
Book,
et je le dis dans mon livre,
well.
Ils ont également souffert
so
de différentes façons.
Suffered,
tout le monde a souffert, mais certains groupes ont souffert davantage. Et certains ont été expressément pris pour cible pour... à des fins de destruction.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Je ne sais pas comment ma question a été traduite, mais je n'essayais pas de suggérer qu'un groupe avait plus souffert qu'un autre.
Je voulais simplement
que vous éclairiez la Chambre sur explain to the chamber or describe to the chamber
the specific impacts of the DK policies on two categories, the new people and the base people. But maybe to focus on the base people, can you explain what was the impact of the DK policies on the base people, and in particular, what was the impact of collectivization on the day-to-day life of the people in the villages that had not yet been liberated, that is to say, people who were still among the base people.
One thing that's somewhat difficult with categories is they imply
les catégories
a homogenous
posent une difficulté.
Group. And when you use these terms, it's difficult because people have different histories within it. And maybe if we can think, again,
this is somewhat off the cuff,
but of variation within the group of base people,
mais il peut y avoir des variations dans
maybe
le groupe
within
du peuple
that there were a group
base.
That passionately believed
il y a peut-être dans ce groupe des gens qui croyaient passionnément en ce que faisait les Khmer Rouges, des gens qui étaient loyaux aux Khmer Rouges. Il y avait peut-être un autre sous-groupe qui ne penchait pas dans un sens ou un autre de façon manifeste, et encore un troisième groupe qui ne savait pas ce qui se passait. Si on ajoute à ceci les variations dans le temps, il peut y avoir une modification du nombre de personnes dans chaque catégorie. Si l'on commence par 75, la guerre, puis 79, au fil du temps, parmi le peuple de base et bien entendu parmi le peuple nouveau, de plus en plus de gens ont dû tomber dans la troisième catégorie.
Being afraid of purges,
en ne sachant pas ce qui se passait, en ayant peur des purges, des gens qui voyaient d'autres disparaître,
really,
qui essayaient de s'adapter.
Hard, weren't able to eat with their families. I think more and more people
à mesure que la faim progressait, que l'on ne pouvait plus voir ses parents, beaucoup ont perdu leurs illusions.
The cadre who had been trained and
suite
were able
purges,
to
les cadres qui avaient été formés
CPK,
et qui pouvaient
CPK beliefs,
défendre
party line,
les croyances du PCK, la
again,
ligne du parti,
killed, so
ces gens avaient été
well
tués,
sort of
sont arrivés des gens qui étaient moins bien formés, qui étaient moins à même de transmettre les ordres et
so
de
again,
faire passer le message.
It, you know, as base people, as a category that has different subgroupings and also look at
base,
it as well
donc,
as something that changes over time,
you
get a sense for it.
Cela,
and again, if we map
dans le temps,
the upset, I think, increases with everyone over time.
Et donc, je pense qu'au fil du temps, chacun était de plus en plus contrarié par la situation.
Merci. Vous parlez
Thank
dans
you.
Votre ouvrage
book,
du renversement de statut et comment
the change
les...
of status.
Gens du
and
peuple
about
de base,
how the base
ruraux,
people who were rural people, poor rural people,
soudainement pris le contrôle
suddenly
sur
took
les
control
riches urbains.
Over the rich people from the cities. So what was the impact of this reversal
pendant la
during
the
DK period? And
did this reversal a laissé des traces
leave any
dans la
traces in
après
Cambodian society after the DK period?
Thank you. Yes, the, in terms of the reversals, there clearly was a massive reversal that was talked about explicitly. It was recognized on the local ground by people. You know, there are different sayings about it. But it also
local,
set up a situation in which there could be localized instances where people took revenge upon people who were higher status.
Localement des cas de revanche contre des gens plus haut placés, envers qui on nourrissait un ressentiment. J'ai raconté l'histoire d'un enseignant, et je reviens ici à Rome. Une famille avait vécu dans la région, était partie à Kampong Cham, puis était revenue, mais il y avait là un protecteur, et un des cadres protecteurs était victime d'une purge.
And eventually,
les forces de Rome sont arrivées, puis Rome a été contrariée par différents incidents au propos
d'un foulard. Where before you mentioned the killing that took place there, her sister was taken and killed there.
Sa sœur a été emmenée, puis tuée,
as I tell in the book, had a student who
he beat
and who had a grudge, and the student became a member
lequel
of the local militia
est devenu membre d'une milice locale
exacted what was widely perceived as a grudge killing.
Et
so I think this is
vengé
again,
en
tuant. You know, other people could say, well, this person was associated with the old
on
regime.
On pourrait dire
so
que cette personne était associée à l'ancien régime,
level,
donc
based on these reversals where
une attaque au niveau local du fait de ce renversement
and they became,
avec un ressentiment.
Position of power, and they were then able to act upon that and target people. So within everything else, if you think about the waves of killing,
ensuite, les modalités
you know,
des exécutions,
from above,
il y a
des
incitations d'en haut, des ordres,
you also have people on the local
il y a aussi au niveau local des gens qui prennent,
well. So
qui se font justice eux-mêmes, il y a donc des exécutions
from an ideology and a structure of power,
qui
but you also have on the local level instances where
de pouvoir, mais au niveau local
violence
aussi,
has taken place
il y a des cas de violence,
like, you know, begrudgement,
à la suite de ressentiment,
before,
par exemple,
by this
ce qui est rendu possible par ce renversement des statuts. Les interprètes demandent de prier l'orateur de parler un petit peu plus lentement pour faciliter leur travail. Merci.
Je vous remercie et les interprètes me demandent de parler plus lentement, s'il vous plaît. J'ai encore de très courtes questions à vous poser. Je laisserai la place à mon confrère, Lord Chanti. Vous parlez de société égalitaire et je voulais savoir si vos recherches, vos entretiens vous ont permis and your interviews allowed you de tirer des conclusions sur l'égalité réelle ou non entre les hommes et les femmes pendant le Kampuchea démocratique. Et s'il reste quelque chose aujourd'hui dans la société cambodgienne de cette égalité proclamée à l'époque entre les hommes et les femmes.
Thank you. Again, the questions open up
Merci.
More and more sorts of issues, so I apologize for going on a little too long.
Problème,
I think briefly,
the
answer would be that, although, for example, in Cambodia, women have power within the household, and, for example, in terms of running finances, so there are ways in which women have been historically empowered, and you find this in Southeast Asia in general, but I think that when the Khmer Rouge came in one sense they undermined basis of gender power through their policies, but they also empowered women through their ideology. I mean, I think women had much more of an opportunity to advance, although they didn't really go to the top, very top echelons of the DK government. But the very fact, if we go back to Region 41, Yie Yuk comes in, Rom comes in, a number of female cadres came in when the Southwest cadre arrived in this area. So they were in positions of power. You know, even as we say that, you might note that there was also an attempt to sort of erase the differentiation between men and women. So women would cut their hair very short. People would dress in a similar way. So the sort of gender differentiation, in some sense, began to level out as well.
And
in a way, you could almost look at it as if there was a sort of unisex being that was being created, a pure revolutionary. It could be male or female, but that was insignificant to the very fact of being a pure revolutionary. So the answer is complicated, but I think it's necessary to recognize that there was an intent to bring equality, even if there were many inequalities that came with the Khmer Rouge ideology. And that women in some domains were empowered, even as they were disempowered in others.
Même si elles perdaient ce pouvoir dans d'autres domaines.
Je vous remercie. J'ai une dernière question.
Thank you. I have one last
Après la famille, je voulais vous poser une dernière question sur l'individu. Dans votre ouvrage, en page 189, vous expliquez la subordination de l'individu à la société, ce dont vous avez déjà parlé depuis deux jours, et vous indiquez qu'il y avait une tendance à abandonner le pronom « je », « knyom », au profit du « nous ». Que pouvez-vous nous dire sur cette tendance et, encore une fois, est-ce que cela a eu un impact sur la société cambodgienne après
It have an impact
la fin
on Cambodian society at the end of democratic Cambodia.
Thank you, Madame.
Merci, Madame.
The lawyer, yes, the. You know, that's an interesting change that came up, and it's in documents, the I, we, on the one hand, I think it signifies the importance of the collective over the individual. So you speak about we as opposed to, there was a term, for example, the garden of the individual that was used.
Nous avons
so you talk about the collective garden versus the garden of the individual.
Par opposition
this emphasis on the group as more important
L'emphase est mise sur le groupe,
so I think that change reflected that. The flip side was, again, in terms of individuality, which was reviewed, privatism, which were viewed as regressive qualities. You know, the sort of individual distinctiveness was muted,
privée,
and many people as well did not appreciate it. So You know, in terms of dress, everybody's dressing the same.
Beaucoup de gens n'appréciaient pas ce changement.
Right, pour attire, ce qui est des vêtements, tout le monde porte le même vêtement, tout le monde coupe les cheveux courts, sort of avait la même couleur de vêtements. Subject, and on avait donc créé un sujet unisex, générique. Sort of that. And I think, et ceci Pond trouve son épitome dans l'emblème national. Portrays this through figurines, the bleaching of color, through an artist, in an artistic manner, he represents this. Et dans la création artistique. As well, but and he talks about the national emblem, but I think, again, this attempt to erase difference, to have a uniform subject. Men and women still exist, but it's really a uniform revolutionary person that's created.
Existe toujours, mais il y a un être uniforme révolutionnaire qui est créé.
This will be my last question on this issue.
Sur cette question précise du pronom, de l'abandon du je en faveur du nous, est-ce que les recherches que vous avez conduites en 94, 95, 92, quand vous êtes arrivé ici, vous ont permis de constater que cet usage commun du nous persistait dans les villages ou pas du tout? Une question très ouverte. Est-ce que cet usage du nous continuer d'exister dans les années 90 quand vous avez commencé vos recherches?
We or us continue to exist in the 1990s when you started your research.
Thank you for the question.
Merci pour cette question.
The quick answer is I've heard it used before, but by that time people were using I.
Oui, ce pourrait être utilisé auparavant, mais à cette époque des années 90, on utilisait le jeu.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur l'expert, pour vos réponses. Monsieur le Président, j'en ai terminé et je souhaiterais céder la parole à mon confrère Law Chun-Ti, qui a quelques questions à poser à l'expert. Merci beaucoup.
President, yes, you may proceed.
Le président, oui, vous pouvez poursuivre.
L'agenté, thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Good afternoon, Your Honours.
Bonjour, honorable juge.
And my respects to the man who sits in the public gallery, and my name is Law Chun-Ti.
Je suis Law Chun-Ti.
I'm representing the civil parties.
Je représente les parties civiles.
Mr. Expert, good afternoon.
Monsieur l'expert.
I'm very much
bonjour.
Interested in your testimony regarding Buddhism.
Votre déposition nous intéresse, notamment en ce qui concerne le bouddhisme.
And I have some questions to put to
j'ai
you.
J'ai quelques questions à vous poser.
My first question is
la
in relation to your statement
en rapport
that
avec
you said
votre déclaration
concept from Buddhism.
Le concept,
in
le concept du bouddhisme était utilisé
implementation of the ideology of
dans
the
la mise en œuvre
Kampuchea
de l'idéologie du Cambodge démocratique
to persuade, those Cambodian people
afin de persuader
to lose track of
les
their conscience. Can you provide a little bit further elaboration on this matter?
De leur conscience. Est-ce que vous pouvez développer sur ce point?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Civil Party.
Merci,
Monsieur
la partie civile, Monsieur le co-avocat.
Yeah, I think this is a very important point that
c'est un point très important que
again,
vous venez de soulever une fois encore.
It gets back to many the sort of fundamental issue of how you motivate people to join
liées à la motivation des personnes, comment pousse-t-on des gens à aller à se rallier à un mouvement génocide ou révolutionnaire, quel que soit le mouvement.
One in which you had
nous avons un
people living in the countryside,
des personnes vivent dans la campagne,
the main audience.
C'est
for the Khmer Rouge, who they wanted to mobilize, and they had to play upon their sense of understanding. People, because they lived near the pagoda, many of them had been educated in the pagoda, they were familiar with Buddhist terms.
Et puisque
so
ces
in order
vivent
to bring people
autour
in,
des pagodes, ils ont une compréhension du bouddhisme,
to couch things
il faudra donc envoyer
in a framework that had resonance for them.
Dans un cadre qui a une certaine résonance pour
Buddhism,
eux. Ils ont donc utilisé
and
des termes du bouddhisme qu'ils ont ralliés à leur idéologie, qu'ils ont intégrés à leur idéologie.
The way, right, the party line, the way, as the Buddhist way, the path towards enlightenment.
Donc, so you have the DK party line
that has the same sort of term. If you follow the line, you will lead to the better society in the same way that by following the way, the Buddha's way, you'll be led to Nibbana. So that was one example. Another one was the renunciation idea that I mentioned before, but there are many examples in my book.
Plusieurs autres analogies dans mon livre.
Thank you.
Je vous remercie.
Allow you to provide some important concepts in relation to the way the Buddhist practice. For example, on the Buddhist holiday,
that is,
Cambodian people who were Buddhist practice the five-way of practice of Buddhism. That is, not to steal or not to kill animals,
à savoir ne pas voler, ne pas tuer les animaux.
And not to involve with other people's wives.
Ne pas prendre les épouses des autres.
And not to lie to other people.
Et ne pas mentir.
And the last point, that is, not to involve with drug or alcoholic substance.
Ne pas consommer d'alcool.
So through your research,
à travers
did
vos
you
recherches,
come across
dans vos recherches,
the points that maybe the Democratic Cambodia actually used part of these five practices in their ideology?
Avez-vous constaté adopté ces cinq préceptes dans leur idéologie?
Thank you, Mr. Civil Party co-lawyer.
Monsieur le co-avocat,
you know, very good point.
C'est un très bon
point. Remind me to make one clarification.
My argument is
not that the Khmer Rouge
mon
were Buddhist,
pas que les Khmer Rouge étaient des Buddhistes,
or that their ideology was Buddhist, but that they drew upon Buddhism.
Mais
and
ils se sont
you know, you pointed out another example,
vous avez
five moral precepts.
Un autre
I think
exemple,
the thing that the analog with Khmer Rouge ideology
et
was the sort of moral precepts that revolutionaries needed to follow. So there's a list of things that each revolutionary qualities, acts they needed to do that weren't the same as those five, but it was the idea of having moral precepts that needed to be followed. Another example, as I sort of think about it, is the notion of mindfulness, as in meditation, to focus your consciousness. That as well was something that emerged with Khmer Rouge ideology, the idea that you needed to be mindful and focus on the DK party line in everything you did. And so that was another example.
So
there are an attachment as well, in terms of cutting yourself off from attachments. That was yet another way, not in terms of desires and attachments. The notion that you need to cut yourself off from attachments was taken and revamped, but linked, for example, to your attachments to your family members. So you needed to be able to cut those off. So there are many, as you're pointing out, many different complicated ways that they sought to do this. And thank you for leading me to that clarification.
Faire ressortir beaucoup d'autres analogies. Merci de me faire penser à éclaircir ce point.
Thank you.
Merci.
Still on this topic, I
toujours
have another question to put to you.
À vous poser.
In relation to using the words or the precepts from Buddhism,
par rapport à l'utilisation des préceptes et termes bouddhiques,
did the Khmer Rouge actually link the wordings from Buddhism to the so-called criticism
bouddhiques?
And self-criticism meetings?
Aux séances de critique et d'autocritique.
You know, I believe that they did,
réponse,
but I would need to go back and review
fait,
and refresh to make sure that the analogy
mémoire,
in terms of the self-criticism,
that
there was like good qualities and bad qualities, there were things like that, but I would like to go back and review the language before making a determination.
Des principes du bon et du mauvais qui étaient utilisés, mais il faudrait que je revérifie.
Thank you. Because in Buddhism, the monks themselves actually express their shortcomings or lack of quality if they have one.
Leur lacune, ces enfants.
And as you're an expert in anthropology,
en anthropologie,
can you tell the court
whether
anthropology is also related to the study of an ideology that would lead people to engage in good behavior or in bad behavior? Did you come across such a linkage in your study or as an expert in anthropology?
Avez-vous eu à aborder un tel lien dans vos études anthropologiques?
Thank you, Mr. Civil Party co-lawyer, and thank you again for your insight again into the practices and the with the monks. I appreciate that. It's always good to learn insights from others, and I appreciate your mentioning that, so thank you. With regard to ideology,
ideology
is a word that we use to talk about regimes that tend to have a more uniform set of ideas that are imposed on others. But I think it's important to step back and know as well that, for example, the Khmer Rouge would talk about capitalist ideology. So the word ideology can be used in different ways. In the end, I think of it as structures, ways of thinking that exist in all societies. If we talk about ideology as it's commonly talked about, often it's linked to authoritarian regimes as having sort of as a more singular message that they impose upon people. But again, to invoke a term that I mentioned yesterday
from a French
social philosopher, Louis Althusser, who talks about the repressive state apparatus, an ideological state apparatus, but he's speaking about communism, about capitalism, although the terms could just as easily be talked about in terms of the DK regime. So again, ideology is a term, in a way it's deployed to characterize movements. And I think about it more as ways of thinking and what motivates people to do the things they do. But you raise a complicated question about what is ideology. We could go into it in more detail if you want, but it's a big question.
En savoir qu'est-ce que l'idéologie? Je crois que c'est une question vaste.
I wanted to explain to the court is that in order to form such an attractive ideology, what would be the starting point and how much time would it need?
Combien de temps cela prendra?
And whether you can see a comparative view between the
Est-ce
ideology of the DK regime
faire une comparaison
in
avec
terms of
Cambodia
ideologies in other countries?
Par rapport aux idéologies des autres pays.
So if we speak of the,
si
I understand through the translation, the question of parallels between the DK regime and other forms of ideology that might exist in other countries upon whom they drew. So one stream might have been Maoism, Marxist-Leninism, French Stalinist ideology, North Korean models, Khmer Rouge movement was quite eclectic, even if that route, as they say in the statute, it's a Marxist-Leninist movement, and that's sort of the bottom line. But there were these other influences and parallels with other places that were important, as you point out.
Comme vous l'avez vous-même dit.
Thank you, and this is maybe my last question.
Merci, ce serait peut-être ma dernière question.
Through your research and study of the
democratic Cambodia
regime, what is the most important criteria that would lead people to, or lead them to discriminate Cambodian people unconsciously, that is, without thinking,
Cambodia,
just acted naturally and without being aware that was wrong?
Sans avoir conscience que les actes qu'il pose sont négatifs.
Do you mean in general in society
en termes
or
général,
during DK
dans la société,
in
ou pendant
particular?
La période du KD en particulier?
Uh, I refer to the DK period in particular.
De la période du Cambodge démocratique en particulier.
Thank you, Mr. Civil Party.
Merci, Monsieur co-lawyer. Pour les partis civils.
Once again, you've touched upon a deep,
encore,
deep point.
Un point très
on the one hand,
très profond.
You know, as I said, it's hard to focus on one factor because there are many things involved, and I've spoken before about the need to look at a process. But having said that, maybe another way to reframe the question, and this is something in my second book on DOIC that I sort of take up.
You
know, for me, the lesson of that trial is the danger of what I call, and I apologize to the translators because I'm sure this may not be easy to translate, but what I refer to as effacing conviction, and by this what I mean is that we all believe and have investments in things.
Pour
we
ça,
all have belief.
Dire par là que nous
when
avons
we
tous
have
des croyances,
belief in something, even if it's very passionate belief,
chose,
the danger
is
that if we have beliefs that lead us to not see another person
si
and the humanity of the other person,
qui nous empêche de voir l'humanité
right, we
en
efface
l'autre personne,
or erase their humanity. So to me, it suggests, and I talk about this in the book that's forthcoming, about the importance of another French word, effacement, which is to recognize the humanity of another being. So we all, having conviction is part of what makes us human. Having conviction also has a potential danger in that it can lead us to do things that harm other individual beings. So in our conviction, it's absolutely imperative to recognize the humanity of another person and to have a facing conviction as opposed to effacing conviction. So in another book, that's how I conclude with this point. Having said that, you know, you have the larger, broader processes that are involved, but if I had to crystallize it down, as I think you're saying, sort of the lesson that I got out of much of my studies, it's the dangers of effacing
Donc la leçon que je tire de la plupart de mes recherches, c'est le danger de l'effacement de la conviction.
Thank you very much, Mr. Expert and Mr. President. I am done.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, Monsieur l'Expert.
President,
Honorable
thank
juge,
you. And I think Judge Laverne would like to put some questions to the expert. Do you mind the floor, Judge Laverne?
Juge, Monsieur le Juge, vous avez la parole.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, thank you, Mr.
Monsieur
President.
L'expert, j'aurais quelques questions de suivi
expert,
à vous poser,
I would like to put
et notamment
a
par rapport à ce que vous avez dit aujourd'hui et
hier,
in relation to what you said yesterday and today, une
regarding the idea of fashioning a revolutionary consciousness.
Est-ce que j'ai bien compris ce que vous avez dit hier?
Did I properly understand what you said yesterday? If I were to say that in the Khmer Rouge ideology, it was possible
toute personne puisse être rééduquée
for everyone
afin d'être
to be
façonnée
re-educated
dans cette
in order to be refashioned
afin cette conscience révolutionnaire.
And made to suit that ideology as part of
principe de base
the
qui était
forging of revolutionary consciousness. Was this a basic principle that was inculcated, that you learned about?
Thank you, Your Honor.
Merci, Honorable Juge.
So the quick answer would be yes.
La réponse rapide serait oui.
In the abstract, as a principle, the answer is yes.
Dans l'abstrait, en principe, la réponse est oui.
But I think it's important to look at temporality
mais il est important
as well,
de regarder
and maybe think of it as what is the greater or lesser likelihood of a group being able to do this. And as the DK regime proceeded, I think the likelihood of certain groups being able to do so diminished.
Je crois que la
but again, this
que
goes back to this idea that I mentioned before of cumulative radicalization, where if initially there was a notion that maybe
parlé,
former Khmer Republic officials needed to be eliminated. Maybe in part because of the patronage
Khmer
connections, also because they're unlikely to be able to sharpen their consciousness, so to speak.
In
the countryside, in many areas, the attacks on people weren't
Donc,
taking place. But over time, as the regime
campagne,
felt threatened, the likelihood of certain groups being able to reform their consciousness, as we say, seems to have diminished, and certain groups seem to have been stigmatized. sont devenus stigmatisés. You know, it's not possible. So if we go back to Muslim Johns, the likelihood of them being able to fashion their consciousness over time was viewed to have diminished, especially after the rebellions that took place. And at that point, they seem to have been targeted because they were Johns, and Johns as a group seemed unlikely to be able to reform their consciousness. I've mentioned before with regard to ethnic Vietnamese, I think that that term, there's more of a streak of racism that's there from the very beginning, that's the current that's running, and I think that especially after tensions, though there is a temporal aspect in the sense that tensions with Vietnam increased, the likelihood that some of those ethnic Vietnamese could reform their consciousness decreased, though I expect that the sort of pre-existing animus that existed towards ethnic Vietnamese had its own sort of strong current that led towards their targeting and elimination. But certainly this then goes to other groups such as, nobody talks about, the notion of ethnic Chinese, the demographic reports say died at perhaps 50%, seems to me another group that was targeted in part because they came from the cities, they were associated with capitalism, but as a group, there is a suggestion that they were being explicitly targeted because the likelihood, again, of their being able to sharpen their consciousness was diminished. If we move to 1978, if we go to the Isom, when the purges began, and these purges were distinct because, many people died everywhere. When we got to the East Zone, we had large-scale purges that went beyond the sort of purges that had been taken elsewhere, and large numbers of the population began to be targeted. And it's possible, again, so the likelihood of this group being able to sharpen their consciousness, so to speak, seems to have been much diminished. And I think you could argue that the East Zone, the people who were targeted were part of a national group. With that part, going back to the UN Genocide Convention, the term national group is one that's somewhat hard to define. It's debated, but I think within the terms of the convention, that's a possibility to look at the purge of the East Zone group and the people who were targeted, as well as genocide. So the question you raised, the answer is yes. If you look at ideological pronouncements, but over time, it changes in different groups, the likelihood increases or diminishes.
La probabilité, selon le groupe, augmentait ou diminuait.
Je voudrais revenir brièvement sur ce que vous avez dit par rapport au Cham.
Vous avez dit qu'il y avait eu une évolution
et que, au fur et à mesure du temps qui est passé, le groupe des Cham, en tant que tel, a été perçu comme étant incapable de se façonner à la conscience révolutionnaire.
Alors,
est-ce que vous pouvez nous dire, vous avez dit que c'était à cause de la rébellion, mais est-ce qu'il y a d'autres facteurs qui ont pu jouer
je pense
notamment à la religion. Were taken into account.
For instance, religion,
sont de religion since the Cham
are of the Muslim religion
a été un des facteurs
was
qui the pris en compte
Islamic religion one of the factors taken into account
ou ne permettant pas cette prise de conscience révolutionnaire.
Didn't allow for this revolutionary consciousness refashioning.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Merci, Honorable
yes,
juge.
I did not mean to imply that it was solely because of the rebellions that they were targeted.
If we return to the notion of the crystallization of difference,
people are clearly in Cambodia aware of the differences between the identity differences of Cham and ethnic Khmer. So that awareness pre-existed DK. When you had the rebellions, those differences became more accentuated, I guess, as well with the question that was asked by the Civil Party co-lead lawyer, as well that sort of plays into this about men and women at the same thing. The idea is you have a uniform revolutionary person with a pure consciousness. That vision does not afford
ayant une conscience révolutionnaire, une
as open to a notion of ethnic difference. And I think as well, if you look at policies, for example, in former Soviet states as well, the different republics, you had this playing out, the former Yugoslavia is a dynamic as well. But you had people, if you can't fashion yourself into the proper revolutionary being, for whatever reason, you become suspect, you become a target. And groups that are identified, who have practices that were viewed as privativism, as regressive, as not conforming to that uniformity that's being sought, then become targets. So absolutely, religion and religious practices play into it because those don't accord with revolutionary ideals. But again, you know, so there were things that were taking place before 1975, but I think the rebellions themselves contributed to this process of cumulative radicalization by which they increasingly became targeted. And then, as I've talked about, the one example linked to my research that shows in Kampong Siam district where all the Cham were taken away, by that time they had become targets, and there were orders that came down targeting them. Et so the answer, it's a long response to the question to say yes, religion is absolutely important, oui, as are the rebellions. They come together as a number of factors that lead to them to be viewed as a counter-revolutionary suspect group.
Qui, de groupe révolutionnaire, de groupe contre-révolutionnaire, pardon.
Donc, si la révolution, si la religion est importante, so c'est parce qu'elle permet d'identifier les Cham comme étant possiblement contre-révolutionnaires. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris ce que
vous dites? Ou est-ce qu'il y a d'autres choses à comprendre? Thrust of your answer, or there are other factors that should be taken into account?
Yeah, thank you, Your Honor. The Chams would qualify as a religious group.
Les Cham peuvent être considérés comme un groupe religieux.
Them, as well
si on
as
essaie de les définir, en plus d'être un groupe ethnique, je pense.
You know, the UN Genocide Convention, as I'm sure
la Convention des Nations Unies sur le génocide, comme vous le savez,
are translated categories,
que parfois
the categories that emerge through a discussion
prior
to the passing of the convention were never fully defined. And so if you go to different localities, if you do Hutu and Tutsi, for example,
si on prend les Hutus et les Tutsi, par exemple, parfois c'est difficile de définir quel est le groupe. Mais pour les Jams, je pense que ça tombe dans la catégorie de la religion, groupe religieux, pris pour cible partiellement pour ses croyances religieuses qui ne coïncidaient pas avec l'idéologie du Kampuchea démocratif, la notion de citoyen uniforme, révolutionnaire pur qui devait être forgé.
Because of that,
et ils ont été pris pour cible de ce fait, de fait de leur coutume, car ils se sont rebellés, ils avaient une autre langue, ils s'habillaient différemment. Des marqueurs ethniques, comme disent les anthropologues.
Alors, si j'ai bien compris ce que vous avez dit, le groupe des Vietnamiens, les choses étaient un peu
différentes.
Une approche beaucoup plus raciste.
There was a much more of a racist approach towards the Vietnamese.
Est-ce qu'on peut dire
so
que dès le départ, il était considéré que les Vietnamiens
the Vietnamese
ne pourraient jamais être
were
éduqués.
Considered
est-ce
as
que,
being impossible
est-ce que c'est quelque chose qui est ressorti de vos recherches?
Is this something that you saw in your research?
Thank you, Your Honor. Yes, that was. That's what I would argue is that, you know, as I said before, even going back to the Khmer Republic and the attacks there,
you know,
that was one instantiation of a long-standing tradition that's existed where at times ethnic Vietnamese would be targeted. So that's a stream that existed.
Maybe we
call it racist.
Une tendance qui existait, on pourrait la qualifier de raciste, même si le terme de race est difficile à définir en Khmer, mais c'est une tendance raciste, ils étaient stigmatisés, il y avait toutes sortes de stéréotypes qui leur étaient attachés, et en parallèle, il y avait les relations qui s'étaient avec le Vietnam.
Donc,
au départ, il y avait l'animosité envers les Vietnamiens de souche. Elle était plus prononcée
au début. Et
came on
later with ethnic Jam. So if you had to map it out, right, the trajectories would be slightly different, even if you end up with the same thing, which is
avec
les Cham,
dans le cas des Cham,
members of both groups.
Donc l'évolution était différente dans le cas des Cham et des Vietnamiens, même si au bout du compte, le résultat était le même, avec
the figures appear to be 100% Jams, well, I won't get into the debate about numbers, but
pour les Vietnamiens, on pourrait parler de 100% de Vietnamiens disparus, pour les Jams, 36-37% peut-être, jusqu'à des chiffres plus élevés, sans vouloir entrer dans les chiffres. Il y a, par exemple, les chiffres de M. Osman qui sont plus élevés, mais je sais que vous allez devoir débattre de ces chiffres.
J'aurais une dernière question à vous poser question to put to en lien avec ce que vous avez dit par rapport à, said, à la déshumanisation. Le titre de votre livre, c'est « Pourquoi ont-ils tué ?» Et c'est vrai que quand on lit votre livre, on voit parfois des, book, des scènes qui sont particulièrement terribles. Je pense à des scènes de cannibalisme,
par exemple,
on fait état de...
Where you speak about people eating livers of people who were killed, or eating gallbladders.
C'est des phénomènes qui sont difficiles à comprendre. C'est des phénomènes this is something that's hard to understand, and this is something that's not necessarily proper to the decay period. But what can you tell us regarding this, and what can you tell us in particular vis-à-vis the decay context? What can you tell us about these phenomena, which seem to be extreme examples of dehumanization?
Thank you, Your Honor. That's a very good question, one we haven't really touched upon.
Qu'on a pas encore vraiment abordé.
There are a couple of different dimensions
Il y a
to
différentes
it.
Dimensions.
As an anthropologist, part of what I seek to convey is the experience, the lived experience of the people with whom I did interviews and with whom I spoke. And the consumption of human liver and gallbladder was something that appeared in conversations regularly, with specific examples provided. So in one sense, that topic speaks to the experience of people, and it's a question that people ponder. Why do people do this? And I believe in court here you've had examples of it as well.
Je pense qu'il y a des exemples the second ici inner aussi, le procès.
Linked issue to, as an anthropologist is that there's a tendency to look, you know, popularly in the media and elsewhere, but also
médias,
in popular ways of understanding violence, to say, oh, someone commits this horrible act, therefore they're a savage.
Violence, telle personne a commis un acte
barbarian.
Horrible, c'est donc un sauvage, un barbare.
That form of discourse dehumanizes
ce type de discours
as well
revient aussi à
by
déshumaniser
the person
la personne,
who's doing those acts in a reductive, essentialized manner.
Et on est réduit
the title
à une
of my forthcoming book is Man or Monster,
mon livre
which
isn't
to pose the question in either or, but it's to
Je
raise the question of how we look at perpetrators as well.
L'un ou l'autre,
and the fact by trying to cast them in a reductive manner, we reduce
crime.
Their humanity.
Et en réduisant
so it's important
les gens
to
à
recognize,
monstre, leur humanité.
You know, for example, with the lead from the leadership of the CPK
dans
down
le cas
to
des
the local
du
level
du
where
PCK
people were involved in the actual physical killings.
These are all human beings,
and we need to recognize their humanity as people.
Prendre
and not
conscience,
to
reconnaître leur
them,
humanité
to them
sans
as savage,
les
barbaric.
Réduire, sans
and as
les réduire
the third,
à des sauvages,
sort of third
des barbares.
Of this, in explanations of violence, you tend to have a series of reductive explanations of violence. For example, immediately after,
violence,
or during and after the Holocaust,
par exemple, juste après
you had the portrayal of the Nazis
les
as sadists.
Dépeints comme des sadiques.
So the notion was it was sort of a Freudian framework that talked about them as being sadistic killers. And it's a word that appears again and again. So ultimately, if you look at that explanation, it seems to suggest that there's a sadistic tendency in a person that leads them to do what they do, as opposed to looking at the broader historical social context that led them to carry out a behavior. Another common one is that there's somehow a sort of cultural proclivity. Okay. You know, but this is in some sense important to lay out because it's a common perception.
Parce que c'est une
so people talk about a biological proclivity, a cultural proclivity to carry out acts of violence.
À se livrer
and all of these
violence.
Reduce explanations.
Et tout ceci,
and again, with the Deutsch trial, to go back to this one thing, the headlines read,
le procès Deutsch,
Man
dans
or
les
monster.
Journaux, les gros titres disaient,
so these aren't things
monstre.
That happened in the past. These are things that
ce
are active.
Des choses
I assume
sont
if I looked at the papers with the defendants in this case as well, that there would be
si
sort of dehumanizing, reductive ways of characterizing them.
Lis ce qu'on décrit au sujet des accusés, ils sont parfois déshumanisés, notamment dans la presse. Et il faut rappeler l'humanité de ceux qui participent à ce procès. C'est une longue réponse, c'est pour ça que je rentre dans le détail.
the moral and the structures of meaning that informed action
in
this
des
case.
De signification
and we always need to be attuned to that. And again, it goes back to this notion of effacing conviction as opposed to effacing conviction.
Plutôt que d'affaissement de la conviction.
Quand on examine
when
ce qui s'est passé, ce que
look
vous avez
at
dit,
what happened and what you described,
est-ce que on peut dire que les bourreaux ou les ceux qui ont exécuté
executioners
sont allés au-delà
went beyond
de ce qui leur était véritablement demandé
required from them, what was asked from them.
Si oui,
and if that was the case,
pourquoi?
Why?
Yes, thank you. This is, you know, in terms of connecting down to the local level, how do we understand it? So
local,
the quick answer is yes, they go beyond,
rapide, oui.
Because
cela
all human beings
loin,
and what they do
tout être humain dans ses
create
actions,
meaning.
They
draw upon the structures of understanding that they have to carry out acts. This goes back to what anthropology is and culture as the schemes that lead us to think and act in different sorts of ways. And so again, for me, as an anthropologist, what's of interest is to try and understand how an act like human liver eating can take place.
And
the type of research is talking to people to find out the local understandings of this act, and then I present those. So the quick answer is
yes,
they exceed orders. But again, you have one has to keep in mind that there is a broader dissemination of an ideology.
C'est qu'une idéologie a été
and there are orders that go down targeting certain groups.
Il était ordonné
so
de
it's not as if those actions
groupe.
Are completely
si
disentangled from the larger ideology and structure, command structure that exists. They can be linked, even as the people on the ground to understand
même
them,
si
as opposed to simply saying
terrain,
they follow orders, to understand the meaning of what they do.
Pouvaient comprendre la signification de leurs actes, même s'ils disaient ensuite qu'ils obéissaient aux ordres.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hinton. I have no further questions to put to you.
President, thank you.
Le président.
Professor, it is now convenient time for a short
merci.
Break. The chamber will take a break from now until 3 o'clock.
Les débats reprendront à 15 heures. Huissier d'audience.
The expert at the waiting room reserved for him.
Vous occupez de l'expert en le conduisant à la salle d'attente pour ensuite le ramener dans le prétoire pour 15 heures.
The court is now in recess.
Suspension d'audience.